In this session, we are going to enable the network to be offline. It's very good when an application has functionality to continue working offline. There are many reasons for an application to be offline, such as bad weather, a power outage, or even driving into a dead zone. Here's our application under test. Most of the times I use Chrome, but not this time. For some reason, Chrome does not include the same offline functionality as Microsoft Edge. I'm going to right-click, inspect, and go to the network tab. The network drop-down, throttling has different options. We're going to select offline. Refresh. Yes. And notice the message says you are not connected. And it also shows internet disconnected. A lot of applications stop right here and do not let us continue. However, we can still perform an action while offline. Do you see "want to play a game while you wait" and this launch game button? Let's inspect this launch game button. And we see the ID value is game hyphen button. Now, at this point, we're going to do the same steps in our automation. In our test, we're going to set the network to be offline, then click this launch game button. It's a surf game. For our test script, I already have Edge driver, DevTools, and the setup method for Edge driver. It's from the last session when we slowed down the network connection using 3G and access LinkedIn. Now let's write at test, public void enable offline network. We always begin by creating the session. DevTools dot create session. This will start a session in the Edge browser. Next is to send a command so we can enable the network. DevTools dot send network dot enable. The enable method has three parameters and all three of them are optional. Therefore, we write optional dot empty, comma. And I'm going to write that two more times, or paste it two more times, and make sure to add the semicolon. If I hover enable, the description shows enables network tracking. Network events will now be delivered to the client. Those three parameters are buffer size, max total buffer size, max resource buffer size, and max post data size. After enabling the network, we are going to send a command to emulate the network conditions. DevTools.send network.emulate network conditions. Hover the method, and this shows activates an emulation of the network conditions using five parameters. The five parameters are offline, latency, download throughput, upload throughput, and connection type. I don't see it here, but connection type is optional. Now, let's go ahead and continue with our test script by writing the value for offline, and that value will be true. This means yes, the network will be offline. 10 is the value for latency. Latency is sometimes called lag. It's a delay in communication across the network. 100 for the download throughput. 50 for the upload throughput. Throughput refers to the amount of data that's transferred from the source to the destination. For connection type, we write optional.of. Connection type dot. and we see the different G connections. But let's select Wi-Fi. And I gotta make sure to add this semicolon. Now let's add a listener and what we expect. And we write devtools.addListener. At this point, I'm going to write some data inside the add listener, some parameters. And that starts with loading failed, comma, loading failed. And we are going to select the example with the lambda expression, because there are two options. Now we write assert equals. And inside assert equals, we're going to write loading failed. And we're going to select the one that do not have parentheses. Dot get error text. Bingo. Remember when we saw internet disconnected after setting the network to offline, then refreshing the page? That's what we expect. So I'm going to write net 2 colons err underscore internet disconnected. And I hope I spelled it right. The last step is to load the page. Since it's offline, let's try to load the page by writing driver.get. The value is https://google.com. Next is to catch the possible exception. That exception is web driver exception, exe, and click the button by writing driver dot, yes. Do you see the extra find element by options? We have these options because our type is edge driver. It's been available to us for a long time, the same with Chrome driver and Firefox driver. However, they're supposed to be deprecated for Selenium 4. I spoke about this in the introduction to Selenium 4, the first video. I'm going to select driver.findElement by ID. The value was game-button.click. Also, print the page. Print the page by writing offline driver.getTitle. Let's go ahead and add this part here in parentheses or quotation marks that says page did not load. That's it. And let's run. It passed, and we see the game. Now, for our console, let's see what it shows. Enable offline, and we see the console showing offline www.google.com, and the page did not load. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you the next session. I create videos every week. And if you're interested in videos that I create, feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon. Also, follow me on Twitter, connect with me on LinkedIn and Facebook, and I will make sure to place the transcript and code on GitHub. And I'll see you later.